Suppose the cost of producing X DVD players is given by the function C of X equals 5,000 plus 5X plus 0.01 X squared. So first we're going to start with how much would it cost just to produce one DVD player? So the cost to produce one DVD player is 5,000 plus 5 times 1 plus 0.01 times 1 squared. And that's going to give us $5,005.01. What about the cost to produce two DVD players? So to produce two DVD players, we get $5,000 plus 5 times 2 plus 0.01 times 2 squared, and that gives us $5,010.04. So the average cost, if we're just producing one DVD player, is C of 1 divided by 1. And that's going to give us $5,005.01. But the average cost for each DVD player, if we're producing two, so C of 2 divided by, we're producing two, so that is going to give us $2,505.02. So we see that our average cost as we produce more and more DVD players is going down. So now let's find the average cost of producing 500 DVD players. So C of 500 equals 5,000 plus 5 times 500 plus 0.01 times 500 squared. And that's going to give us $10,000. So it costs $10,000 to produce 500 of them, but the average cost, C of 500 divided by 500, so 10,000 divided by 500, is just $20. So the average cost of producing 500 DVD players is just $20, which means that you can sell them for a lot less and still make a profit. Companies also care about something called a marginal cost function. So if we go back to this idea that to produce just one DVD player, we found cost $5,005.01. And to produce two DVD players, it costs $5,010.04. So marginal cost is wanting to know how much it costs to produce one additional item after we produce one. So how much does that second DVD player cost us to make? So if we know that the cost to produce one DVD player and the cost to produce two, we can subtract, so the cost to produce 2 minus the cost to produce 1 will tell us how much it costs just for that second DVD player. So the cost to produce 2 items is $5,010.04 minus the cost to produce 1 item, $5,005.01, and that's going to give us $5.03. If we look at this on a graph, so here's the cost to produce one item, and here's the cost to produce two items. The cost to produce that second item is this distance here, so C of 2 minus C of 1. And if we think about this, we know that the distance along the x-axis between the two is 2 minus 1, and that's just 1 unit. So the cost to produce that second item is the same as the change in our y over the change in our x, which is the slope of the secant line between C1 and C2. And we can relate this to derivatives because if we find the derivative of our cost function, that is the limit as our change in x goes to 0 of our change in y, or in this case, our change in our function c of x, over our change in x. And as long as that slope change is very minimal, then that is going to be approximately the slope of our secant line. So we can approximate the cost of producing that second DVD player by finding the derivative at c of 1. So c prime of x equals, if our function is 5,000 plus 5x plus 0.01x squared, then the derivative is 5 plus 0.02x, and in this case, we're finding the cost of producing that second item, so we're just going to plug in 1. So c prime of 1, the slope of our tangent line at 1, is 5 plus 0.02 times 1, which is $5.02, which is a very good approximation to the actual cost that we found of $5.03. So let's test this again to find the marginal cost, or the approximate cost, to produce the 501st item. So we find c prime of x is equal to 5 plus 0.02x, and if we're trying to find the cost of the 501st item, then we're going to find the derivative at 500. So c prime of 500 equals 5 plus 0.02 times 500. So our marginal cost, or the approximate cost to produce the 501st item, is going to be $15. So let's check to see how good our approximation was using our derivative. If we find the cost to produce the 501st item, that's 5,000 plus 5 times 501 plus 0.01 times 501 squared, which gives us $10,015.01. And our cost of producing 500 items, which is 5,000 plus 5 times 500 plus 0.01 times 500 squared, gives us 10,000. So C of 501 minus C of 500 is going to be 10,015.01 minus 10,000, which gives us $15.01. So we find that using the derivative to find the approximate cost to produce one more additional item, our marginal cost, is a very good approximation to finding that cost of producing just one more item.